Hello boys and girls, my name is Miss Chloe, and if you've been watching any of my videos, I have previously stated I am a STEAM teacher, and I teach science, technology, engineering, art, and math, and the company I work for is Snapology. So, boys and girls, this week we are going to be diving into the medieval times. We're going to do a few videos on the medieval times to really be able to grasp some concepts about where we were then, and how kings and queens ruled the lands. So in this lesson, students, we're going to be brought into the fantasy world of fairy tales with kings, queens, knights, wizards, and dragons. And today's build will be focused on some of those things. So when you think of a king or queen or dragons, what's the first thing that comes to mind? And I'll give you a second to answer that. Okay. The first thing that comes to my mind is a castle. Okay. When I think of a dragon, I think of it's sitting on the castle. Or if I think of a king or queen, I think of them in their castle. All right. And so we're going to be kind of going into that. And this lesson's going to kind of help to show the world who they are and what they do. All right. So, diving into the lesson, royal families headed by the kings and queens have been in the world for centuries. Even today, some regions are ruled by kings and queens. All right. And today there are other types of leaders, like prime ministers we have and presidents who oversee countries. But kings and queens, like I said, they are still around, which is super fascinating. If we look at how time has changed, which we'll get into more detail later, kings and queens go way back, okay? In some modern day countries like Sweden and Japan, royal families are ceremonial leaders without any true government power, okay? In other countries like Saudi Arabia, they are autocratic leaders with absolute no authority, all right? Kings and queens first came into being because people decided they did not want to rule themselves. The people didn't want to rule themselves, and so they chose their leaders, okay? Sometimes kings and queens inherit their titles, though, all right? Because they were born into the royal families. So for example, if a king had a son, then the son would take over as king one day. He'd be the prince, all right? We're going to, once again, grab your base plates. If you don't have a big base plate, that's okay. You can make one, or if you have a smaller base plate, like a half of this, that's fine, or a full. And the main idea is, for this lesson is, I want you to be creative. Okay, I want you to also use your prior knowledge of what you know from the royal times. Have you watched a movie or read a book where you can think of a medieval period? All right, now did dragons really exist? I'm gonna let you answer that. All right, do you think dragons really existed? Okay. And when you think of the medieval times, what do you think of? Do you think of horses on carriages? Do you think of the castle? Do you think of moats around the castle protecting the royal families with maybe alligators or crocodiles? That's up to you. What I want you to do is be creative. I want you to think of something that stands out. I know, right? And what you're going to do is, we are going to build. Now, in the medieval times, there wasn't a lot of color like there is today. You know, there was a lot of neutral colors, such as soft browns and tans in the buildings. And so you can choose to use those colors, or you can choose to take it to a Dr. Seuss level if you watched my previous video. Now, with that being said, add some detail to your build. And if you have any dragons or if you have any pets, farmland was huge, add it to your build. And get creative and have fun. Most of all, have fun. All right, boys and girls, it was so nice being with you this evening. And I hope you guys all have a fantastic day.